Hey y'all, you in the house with Chrystale.
If I catch you looking at anything else, I'm gonna beat your ass.
We're gonna what? Honey, break out your aprons, get your tool belts, because I have all the tips and the tea. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. Mwah.
Hey, what's up, young kings and young queens? You in the house with Chris. Listen, you guys, two in a row, baby. It is up. It's late again, but oh my goodness, let me grab my apron. I'm putting on this apron because I already got a lot going on, and I'm going to add to it with this cheetah and this red and this tie-dye because it is a lot going on, y'all. So, I'm going to just tell y'all the truth. I'm not even really cooking nothing too spectacular because it is late, but I am hungry. I am just getting off of work, but I had to not just take time, but make time to talk about what's on my mind, happy. Okay, so listen. Y'all have heard about what Viacom NBC did to Nick Cannon. How you gonna cancel Nick Cannon for, this is my question, exercising the First Amendment right, that's freedom of speech? I don't understand what's going on with that, like, how could they really get out of what he said? Because I was like, let me watch. And I don't have a lot of time during the day, y'all. But I was just so blown by it because I was like, what are they talking about? They just canceled Nick Cannon like he's the golden child of NBC, blah, 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 blah. So I was like, oh, I just wonder what he could have said to have them cancel him, okay? So I went back and I watched the video that he, and all he was speaking is what his truth is. He was not, he didn't say, oh, I hate, or these people are fucked up, go after the, excuse my language, y'all, but I'm a little bit bothered because here's my thing, and I love all people. Let me be very clear about that. All people. However, they done sold us white Jesus for years. Nobody canceled their asses because of it. Nobody said, and let's go back over all the years y'all have been selling us white Jesus, and y'all have been hating on the black man, because even your science proves that the oldest bones that y'all ever found was from an African American. So based on your own science, if you don't even want to believe biblically or wherever the books, the history books, depend on y'all science. Nick Cannon didn't lie in what he was saying, and he was not preaching nothing anti-Semiticism, blah, 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 blah. Hey, shut the hell up, okay? And let's say he was blatantly wrong, all out wrong. So let's say he lied. Like how we've been lied to, how our children have been fed in schools that white Jesus, they come from slavery, all of this stuff, made to pledge allegiance to a flag, and we've okay with it. We can't have no, we can't say shit. Now it's even okay for, oh, they can, the children can choose what gender they want to be. That's okay. But we can't choose as a people to speak up on what we believe that our people are, that we believe that we are the chosen people, or if we believe that we are the true Jews, or if we believe that we Jesus walks amongst us. Whatever the case, we're not entitled to be able to say that openly how we feel. But y'all can tell us that we're supposed to let children choose what gender they want to be. If he born with a little dick, he a boy. If she born with a little cushy girl. It's simple. Maybe as people grow up and they make choices in life and they know who and what they like, then yes, okay. But I'm glad I don't have children, because you're not going to force feed down my child's throat that, okay, yeah, you know, it's okay, little Jenny, for you to go take your little coochie off into the little dick bathroom. No, that shit is not okay. Y'all, I'm a little worked up, NBC, and I like This Is Us, and I like good girls, but I ain't watching that shit. And Nick Cannon, I'm standing with you. I hope we all stand with this brother, because you got enough money off out of them to start your own network. Put my show on it, Nick. I'm about to burn my shit up. Y'all, so what I'm doing is my beans that I made a little salty last night, I just added a whole lot of water in there. And I'm just reheating them. I'm reheating them, you know, because this, you know, shit. Y'all, I am pissed off. I just don't believe that they did that, because this man exercised his freedom of speech. And if you go back and you look at the video, he was even saying, I want to be careful in how I word this. You know what I'm saying? But if and again, historically so it has been that a certain culture has been barbaric. And how they have obtained their wealth and land and belongings is by taking. By coming into a society of people who have been peaceful, who have been prosperous, and who have been positive until they were invaded by savages and people who came in and corrupted their system and implemented a system that only worked for them to be in power and to keep certain people on the bottom. It's history. It's not racism. It's not anti-Semiticism, or however the fuck you say that word. Because I was going to put some big ass word out there, tangle your ass up in it. But we ain't falling for that. You're not going to make it into something that it's not. It's freedom of speech, it's history, and it's facts, and it's scientifically proven. And you want to cancel him? Goody, goody goddamn gumdrops. I'm glad you canceled him, because now he could go and do some bigger and better and blacker shit. Fuck you, NBC. Yeah, that's what I said. Anyway, y'all, that's my rant for the day. I'm so pissed off. It's like they just go one thing after another, and then these damn police officers that killed this girl, Brianna. Why y'all still walking around? We gotta do something different, people. Something totally different. Because the system that we relying on is not really fucking with us. It's just showing us time and time and time and time again. If we speak up, if we say how we feel, if we say or talk about what we believe, what we cherish, what we want, they come at us with some shit. No compassion. No compassion whatsoever. Y'all got to watch it. Okay, that's my rant, y'all. I'm going to go. I'm going to go so I can eat and go to bed. And y'all can just think about it. I try not to get too emotional about this shit. But I'm over it. Maybe I need more rest. I'm going to be getting a line now, because I'm about to be watching shit on TV. I love y'all. Bye. And you know what, y'all? Don't I always say I'm done? Then I be thinking about some shit. And this is another thing I'm sick of. I'm sick of them asking us to apologize for saying things that we believe. It's not like, just like the football players. See, I be getting people's names mixed up, you guys. But they want to hear, he said something, he supported something Farrakhan said. He quoted Farrakhan, then they, oh, he's this, he's that. No, listen, if that's what that man feels and that's what that man believes in his heart to be true, then that's fine. That's his First Amendment right. Stop using this financial intimidation to get us to apologize for things that we have every right to believe and to say. We have the right. And when our jobs and our careers should not be threatened because we exercise our First Amendment right. It's people out there calling people niggers, spitting in people's faces, pulling guns on us for peacefully protesting. And only then when people film it, it goes viral and all of this. Oh, these people lose their jobs, or they might get a slap on the damn wrist. But if we say something, okay, we believe we're the chosen people. Okay, we believe we're the true Jews. Okay, we support what Farrakhan says, that baby, we need to get our own houses in order and separate and this and this and that. And that's what we believe. And then that makes us racist. That makes us be oh, y'all, it's a threat. How? Because we are believing and supporting our beliefs and our people and where we descend from, who our descendants are. We're not just only saying, oh, we descendants of Harriet Tubman. We descendants of damn Kunte. Like, goddamn. Can we believe in something and speak about it and speak freely about it and openly about it? Because part of healing is having the conversation and having an honest conversation. We should be allowed to be honest about how we truly feel and who we truly believe that we are. That's ridiculous that I'm fearful to say I'm a proud black woman. This is what I believe. This is where my descendants come from. This is how I believe spiritually, without feeling like I'm going to be financially intimidated that I may not be able to earn for my family based on practicing my First Amendment right. That others can practice freely and just say all kinds of stupid shit on a regular, and if they come with an apology, it's okay. All is forgiven. I'm sick of it. I am so sick of it. I don't know what to do. And I think that y'all are getting sick of it too, because you cannot continue to back a person or a people or a culture or anybody into a corner when they trying to play fair ball. Nick has played fair motherfucking ball with y'all. Okay? And this is what you do. Better be careful. Better be careful. That's all I got to say. This is time out. It's time out for this intimidation for practicing your fucking rights. Time out. And please open your eyes and know what they're trying to do for this election. Okay? We got to get out and we got to vote. We got to figure out a way to vote and not be scared to stand in the lines because of the COVID. We got to mask up and stand in damn line and find the damn polls, because they depending on us to not show up and turn things upside down. All right, y'all, let me fry my fish. Yes, it is. I'm about to fry some damn fish in my seasoning, damn it. On a different note, there's a lady who became a multimillionaire because Aunt Jemima, they take that damn Aunt Jemima off the shelves. And so now this lady, with her syrup formula, it has an opportunity. And that is great. About damn time. Bye, Aunt Jemima. And I like that butter syrup too, but I'm glad this little lady, I'm going to eat some of her syrup. I'm going to do it a recipe and I'll tell y'all how it is. I love you guys. Yeah. We got to pray for real. But like I said, we got to pray, and then we got to be diligent. We got to prayer with action, okay? Because like my grandfather said, you really, all you're doing is crying and praying, you're going to have a wet face and some skin up knees. Time out for that.